Here at TYT Science, we've been going for nearly a month now, just finding our feet, getting our presentation style going and that kind of stuff. And one of the comments that has crept up various times in our videos is, thank God for TYT Science, because when Ana and Cenk try to present anything on science, they invariably butcher it. And I thought, okay, that maybe is a bit harsh, I'm sure it's not that bad. But oh boy. Okay, how do we do this one? Hi, I'm Mike, this is TYT Science, and today we are doing brain control! Brain control! Or why a quadriplegic woman undergoing therapy by means of a small implant into her motor cortex does not spell doom for the world as we know it. Let's go to the video.
Scientists continue to amaze me because they're doing great things, especially for people who are paralyzed. So there's a woman by the name of Kathy Hutchinson. She is one of two paralyzed patients who are now being tested for robotic arms. And these robotic arms are basically manipulated by their own brains. It's a really incredible story. We have a video of this, and it's called BrainGate 2.
Just to chip in here quickly, this is a great story. The original is available on Nature Videos. You can look that up on YouTube. I was going to do this for TYT Science, but didn't get around to it yet. Even if I had done it on the same day, though, I just have to note that the backlog here on uploading for TYT Nation is about a week, so it's very hard to do hot-off-the-press stories and catch that internet traffic. Okay, let's carry on.
Whenever you hear brain gate, you think it's a negative thing, but no, don't worry, it's a great thing. And it shows Kathy Hutchinson manipulating the robotic arm. Let's watch.
Kathy Hutchinson is paralyzed and unable to speak, but just by thinking, she's able to control the movements of this robotic arm and drink her morning coffee.
Our idea is to bypass that damaged nervous system and go directly from the brain to the outside world.
The sensor is a tiny array of electrodes connected to a bundle of gold wires. It's implanted in the patient's motor cortex, the part of the brain that commands body movements. Eventually, the researchers hope to build an arm that works as smoothly as a real one and can cope with more complicated tasks like brushing teeth.
To see her with that robotic arm reach out and pick up that cup of coffee and serve herself that coffee for the first time in nearly 15 years, it was an incredible moment.
Awesome stuff. I've seen some of this before, but it's really developed. Love it. Okay, let's see the commentary.
It's incredible stuff.
All right, I have several conclusions. One, robots, they're not just for Japanese sex robots anymore. Okay, so we're making progress. Number two, it's over. I don't know what it is, but it's over, okay? No, the minute we can control things with our minds, we're gonna have Magneto, we're gonna have, I mean, we're gonna have everything.
No, please. Okay, listen, allow me to demonstrate some brain control for you. Watch. I am controlling my hands, okay? I'm also controlling my voice. I mean, this, and that's how I'm having influence on the world. This poor woman, she cannot control her arms, okay? So she needs a little implant in order to control a bad robot to do that. Now, you could do that with the joystick because you have direct control of your hands or some kind of interface like that. She doesn't, so that she does it via an implant, and that does not signify the end of the world as we know it.
I mean, the dudes are gonna be coming in with drone strikes with their from their head. You're gonna be like, where is it? I don't know, it's the Magneto's head.
Okay, this is plain ridiculous. What is this Magneto thing, okay? I mean, if you're talking about the X-Men, do you mean Professor Charles Xavier, who was in the wheelchair, had the psychic control and hooked up his brain to large machines? Or do you really mean Magneto, who could manipulate magnetic fields in complex ways that we actually can't do? Because, I mean, if you were to stick an electromagnet and battery pack on this woman's wheelchair, well, the best that would come of it would be that she would get stuck in awkward places.
Right? No, it's over. I don't know. I don't know if it's a good thing. I don't know if it's a bad thing. In this case, it starts good, but, you know, it gets twisted for evil later. I mean, come on. You think the Pentagon isn't going to have a guy who's going to have all that stuff in his head, like, zap, nuke,
Whoa. Let's slow things down here and apply a bit of logic, shall we? Now, why would anyone in the Pentagon or anyone in their right mind, want to shave a patch on top of their head, drill a hole through their skull, implant an array of gold electrodes with a massive block sticking out the top of their head and a cable attached, just to do something they could already do with the click of a mouse button. It no makey sensey, people. It doesn't add anything extra. What this paraplegic, sorry, quadriplegic woman is empowered to do is what we already take for granted, because we already have that brain control over our limbs. Now, if you were to get this implant, or I were to get this implant, what extra could we do that we cannot already do by typing commands into a computer, by using a joystick, or using any other manual interface? Really, I'm not seeing World War III happen because of this therapy.
You see what I'm saying?
Now, good. Anna's up next. I like Anna. Come on, Anna. Save us here.
Yeah, I'm curious to see if you can manipulate things from afar. So let's say you're just in the comfort of your bedroom and you're thinking about really, really bad, bad things, right? You want to do bad, bad things to, like, your enemy, or bad, bad things to maybe he's not your enemy.
Yeah, to your man.
And you can manipulate, I don't know, some sort of robotic arm somewhere.
All right. Let's break this down. First up, getting your enemies from afar. Let's compare two scenarios. Scenario one. That was a terrible presentation. Robot in America, kill Ana Kasparian. I'm telling you with my brain. Scenario two. If science quality less than or equals to 50 and presenter equals Anna, then run function kill open brackets and a Kasparian close brackets return. Okay, so what's the difference between these two scenarios? Absolutely nothing. They both are very conscious decisions to go and kill someone, and they would both leave a very strong forensics trail straight to you. I think the fear here is that it's being expressed both by Cenk and Anna, that you've got some scenario which is a bit like the 1950s sci-fi film Forbidden Planet, where monsters from the id go out destroying other people. To get to grips with this, what you need to understand is that this woman who's controlling the coffee cup is making very conscious decisions to do that, and anything going into the motor cortex is going to be exactly that as well. Now, at the back of your brain is the visual cortex. At the side, you've got auditory, you've got sensory here, and all the information that comes in flows forward in your brain to just about here in the frontal lobe, which is your decision-making area. If your body wants to do anything, if it's decided to take that action, then it goes to the motor cortex, which is what we're talking about here, okay? Which is kind of like a post office. You know, the letters, the commands have already been written. They're just getting ready to be sent down through your spinal cord out to your arms and your hands, okay? So you're tapping into decisions already being consciously forced, okay? And that's the only way it's going to be, because if you try to tap into anything lower level where it's just emergent ideas in your brain, then obviously if you were trying to control a robot like that, the robot would be getting fluctuating commands. Maybe I want to do this. No, maybe I don't know. Maybe I've changed my mind again. Maybe I half want to do it. Okay? And who would want to control a robot on the id level and give it all those confusing commands and make it do things before you've decided that you want them to do it? Again, it's no makey sensey territory, okay? But wait, what was the second thing Anna said?
Bad, bad things to maybe he's not your enemy.
Yeah, to your man.
And you can manipulate, I don't know, some sort of robotic arm somewhere.
No. Any girl that would send a robot to, end of relationship on the spot. Really, if that's the future, then I'm very glad I live in the now. Okay, I've been Mike. This has been TYT Science. Be curious, but be good. Thank you.